Right, switching cameras, switching roles. Now, I hope that this inspired you a little bit for today. And we're going to have a look at some of the companies that are involved today in Create Tomorrow. And these companies need your expertise. They need your social entrepreneurship. And one of the challenges comes from the Provincie Overijssel and their quest to create smart cities. Because the department has a city movement, a Stadsbeweging, and it focuses on vibrant cities in collaboration with entrepreneurs, inhabitants, municipalities, and other parties. So we're going to see if we can talk to them. And this is all live. Oh, they're already here. That sounds good.
Hi.
Hi, ladies. So on behalf of Overijssel, Lieke Kiekebos and Iris Boers. Welcome.
Thank you.
Good. How are you?
We're doing good.
Yes? Excited because of all the inspiration and creativity we have already seen.
Yeah, and special circumstances.
Very special circumstances. Yeah, well, so good to have you. Can you tell us a little bit about what you have seen and what you have talked to so far?
Yeah, well, this morning we actually talked to a couple of groups already, and we were very pleased to hear all their interesting and innovative ideas already. And it's still morning, but they are already really creative.
Yeah, it was funny to see because some of the groups have already started yesterday in the evening. So one was wearing a rope on the couch, and others
were just... Oh, a rope! I saw some people in ropes today too, but we'll get to that later. And I heard some people only slept 4 hours, so the students are really excited about the cases.
Yeah, it's great to see.
Yeah.
And why is it so important for you, for the province of Overijssel, to participate as a partner?
Well, we actually don't think that we can come up with everything on our own, so we always like to work together with society. So today we hope to be inspired by the students and with all of their ideas about socially smart cities.
And of course we want to be to show everyone we are an organization which is fun, inspirational to work at. So if someone wants to work at our organization, come and find us.
Yes.
Good, that's very, very confident. But you seem like a lot of fun already. So I think that will
Thank
come
you.
Over. and can you tell a little bit more about, you said you want to be inspired by society, but in this case, you really want to be inspired by a younger generation, by students. What is it so special that students can contribute to an organization like yours?
Well, I think our common goal is common interest, and we work on spatial planning. And students are the future, and these students are studying and have fresh and new ideas. So I think they can contribute a lot to the work we already do.
And of course, they work from their home with other students from different backgrounds. So that's very interesting as well.
Yeah, I really saw that also. I already visited a few student homes, which we'll see in a little bit. But I really saw that there's a beautiful mix of all these different expertises together working on a case. It's very valuable.
Yeah. Yes.
So, of course, what you're doing with the Provincie and the Stadsbeweging is really innovative. Now, how can you implement what comes from today? So the solutions that the students come, how can you implement that in what you're doing?
Well, I think what you already said, as a Stadsbeweging, the city movement, we are always innovative. The case that that the students are working on today, we actually thought about this case before the coronavirus started. Mm. And the scenarios we described are coming true a little bit. So maybe it's a bit scary, but it also shows that we always try to look at the future and try to be innovative and think ahead.
Yeah, which is so important in your position. Can you just tell us briefly a little bit more about your case, about the challenge that you laid before the students?
Well, we suggested scenarios about the city not being a place to buy anymore, so no more shops, And of course, digitalization will make people more individualized, so they will use their phones more, and which is already the case right now. With the COVID-19 crisis, you see already that people had to stay out of the city, and these days, especially on Monday when we can go drink a beer, people want to go to the city. The attraction is high. So we want to find out how we can make the city future-proof, but still a place where people meet each other.
And we thought about this case before the coronavirus outbreak. So the future of the city centers is something of the utmost importance, even before the corona crisis started. So we try to get some very innovative ideas about what the function of the city center can be, apart from maybe going there for shopping.
Yeah, and like you said, of course, the social activities is one of the core things of a city center. But due to COVID and due to this new scenario that we are in, how are you going to implement that in this case? Because it's quite difficult, as social interactions is we're so used to it being live.
Yeah, we said to different groups that they should not be let it hold them back. So we don't know what the future brings. Maybe there will be a vaccine and medicine to so we can be together again in shorter distances than the 1.5 meter now. So we want them to think outside their box and not let them hold it back.
Yeah, the corona crisis is temporary, we hope.
Yeah.
So the situation we are in now, we hope is temporary. So if students can come up with ideas that are helping us now, that's really great. But if they want to think ahead and think about the future that goes a little bit further than the society we live in right now, that's also fine.
Yeah.
Whatever they feel passionate about, we want to challenge them in that direction.
As they reflect society, like you just said.
Yes.
But that's interesting. I mean, that must be quite a challenge also in your work, that you have to think of all these different scenarios and you don't really know, of course, what the future will bring. You've already been speaking to a few of the students. Have certain things, did certain things stand out for you?
Well, we found it very interesting that they think about things they know, about their passion, about their hobbies, about their work, things they do. So it's very interesting to see that they use that in their creation, in their mindset, and that's very very nice to see. We were very surprised about that.
And it's also very interesting to see that every group is choosing a really different approach. And I think that's really interesting.
Yeah, can imagine. You have all these different perspectives that will actually add up to a solution that you're looking for within this case. Last question. You, of course, have all these different scales. You have the cities, you have the villages, you know, you have the big villages, small villages. How have you looked at that within this case? Because I can imagine the solution should be applicable to all these different scales.
Well, the fact is that we work for Overijssel, and the province has more than just cities. So you are completely right that for us, the city is not the only thing that's important. The city center is important, and you also find city centers in smaller cities or villages. They are all important.
Yeah, and you see that in every small town, bigger town, people want to meet each other. So I think what the students can come up with, we have a lot of experts, and I think they have great minds as well. We can adjust them for the right village or town.
Good. I think you have a lot of confidence in the students, and I think that's the best place to begin. Well, Lieke and Iris, thank you so much. And I'm switching from you on the screen to the camera. Thank you so much for your input, for this challenging case, and also for the communication with the students. And I'm sure they're working really hard right now as we speak to make your case to come to a successful solution. So thank you again, ladies, and I hope to see you tonight.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. All right. So I hope you're inspired. I hope you have energy. And I hope you will go back to work now, because we have some thinking time. And I will be back around 2:30 for the rest of the program. And I wish you good luck with your case, and see you then.